Hello students, welcome to RD Chemistry. In this video, I am going to solve some practice question for the NEET. Tomorrow, you are going to write KCET chemistry examination. These questions are also helpful for your KCET exam for tomorrow. Okay, so let us start now. Question number one, if Van 't Hoff factors for the aqueous solution of XYZ are 1.8, 0.8, 2.5. Then, which of the following option is correct? Assuming equal concentration, all the three cases. Now, any colligative property, if it is there, okay, if you let me in terms of colligative property directly proportion number of particles produced in the solution in terms of I value, Van 't Hoff factor. Okay. Now, boiling point. Remember, as the I value increases, okay, boiling point increases, but the freezing point decreases. Osmotic pressure also increases, whereas the vapor pressure, when you dissolve more and more solute, when the more and more particle produced, vapor pressure also decreases. Clear? So based on this, we'll find out. Boiling point, now they are given, say, I'll write in the order 0.8, then 1.8, then 2.5. Okay, 1.8 for X. Okay. 0.8 for Y and the 2.5 for Z value. So boiling point of X is smaller than given. No, it cannot be smaller. Smaller for which one? Okay, 0.8. Got it? So first one is not the correct one. Freezing point of Z is very, very small. Correct. Okay. So here, as the I value goes on increases, freezing point goes on decreases. So maximum decrease for which one? Maximum decrease for the largest value 2.5, that is Z given. Then next highest decrease for which one? X. Okay, 1.x. Then okay, minimum decrease for which one? 0.8, that is Y. Correct. Which means suppose I got 0 degree centigrade, it can be -1 degree centigrade, -2 degree centigrade, and -3 degree centigrade. Clear? Right. As the I value goes on decreases, correct, that is the maximum. So that are the minimum freezing point, goes on decreases. Then it comes say 1.8, this is for the X, and 0.8, say this is for the Y. Okay, so which has got the freezing point, minimum freezing point, say -3 degree centigrade. So that is less compared to -2 compared to -1 degree centigrade. So second one is the correct statement. Osmotic pressure cannot be same for all because there are different I values are there. Vapor pressure, okay. So as the I value increases, vapor pressure goes on decreases, reverse way around. So it is also not matching. So the exact answer is option number B. Clear? Question number two. The most reactive carbonyl compound that react towards cyanohydrin formation with the KCN. So this is a nucleophilic nucleophilic addition reaction. These are nucleo addition. Okay, remember, whenever the R, C, double bond, or R can be hydrogen, R can be alkyl also. Remember, whenever there are aldehydes are highly reactive because on both the sides, one side R is, the other group hydrogen is there, correct? So there is no less steric hindrance is there. In case of aldehyde, there is less steric hindrance. Whenever the ketones are there, more steric hindrance is there. So these are ketones less reactive, aldehydes are more reactive, but among the two alkene, there's a pH benzene ring is there, benzene the bulkier group, what will happen? The react decreases, so highly reactive is a A. First one is the answer. Question number three. An FCC lattice has a lattice parameter A, edge length A, 400 picometer, calculate the molar volume of the lattice including all the empty space. Now, how do you calculate volume in general? Volume is equal to side into side into side, A cube, correct? So, you have to find out. A cube, I have to write in terms of centimeter because it's ml, okay? ml. So, why ml now? Because centimeter cube, 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 ml, correct? So, centimeter into centimeter, centimeter, so centimeter cube. Some centimeter cube you have to write up, correct? This was the only particle. When you see FCC is there, FCC that is equal to 4. For 4 atoms, this is the volume. So A is equal to 400 into picometer 10 power minus 12 meter. Or it is a 400 into 10 power minus 12. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Correct. So it is equal to 400 into 10 power minus 10 centimeter. Or it is a 4 into 10 power minus 8 centimeter. Now I'll do a cube. A cube is equal to 4 into 10 power minus 8 cube madbeku into centimeter cube. Right. Now this was the four atom. Let me write on this that number of atoms and its volume. Okay. So atoms are 4 in number. So corresponding volume is equal to how much? 4 into 10 power minus 8. Okay, centimeter cube. 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 mm. Therefore, molar volume means volume occupied by 1 mole of the particles you take, 6.022 into 10 power 23 atom is take. So what is the corresponding molar mass? So when you calculate all these things, the final answer would be equal to 9.6 centimeter cube barute, which is nothing but 9.6 mL barute. Okay, so the answer is option number 4. Clear? Right? Question number 4. In which of the following polymers strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding is present? Hydrogen bonding is present. Cellulose, glucose derivative contains OH group. So there's a hydrogen bonding possible. Nylon is a polyamide. Okay. So there can be the strongest intermolecular bonding like hydrogen bonding possible between the two polymeric chain. PVC, polyvinyl chloride, polyisoprene are the polymers. They are very stretchable, so there are weak van der Waals force of attraction. Weaker bonds are present. Okay, so therefore, cellulose and nylon should be the answer. Option number D is the answer. Clear? Question number 5. Organic or aromatic amine X treated with the alcoholic KOH and another compound Y. False milling isocyanate form. Phenyl isocyanate. So actually, this is a carbylamine reaction. Okay, carbylamine reaction. And methyl isocyanate is obtained from the benzene attached to the NH2. Okay, so we require carbamation chloroform and we require alcoholic KOH. This will give rise to benzene ring attached to the NC isocyanate. So that is called the carbamine. Okay, right. Okay, so this is X now, and alcoholic potash already mentioned, and the another compound is Y. Okay, so chloroform is Y now. So now the compound Y is formed by reacting with the chlorine and slaked lime. Slaked lime is a calcium hydroxide. We should get chloroform CHCl3. Now, if you observe carefully this one, there are chloroform cannot be the answer. Acetone, ethyl alcohol, and the ethyl, sorry, benzene, sorry, phenylamine is there. Phenylamine, benzenamine is there. Benzene already we have used in the reaction here. Okay. So now among the two compound, now carefully see chlorine halogen and some base OH minus. Okay, this is generally for the haloform reaction we make. Haloform reaction that will produce us the haloform like chloroform, iodoform, and bromoform. Now to answer haloform reaction, compound must contain CH3CO group. Correct. So therefore, answer is B option. Acetone is the answer because acetone will give the methyl will give iodoform and the sodium salt or the calcium salt or the carboxylic acid remaining part. That means CO CH3 must be there in the organic compound. Correct? It breaks here and this part is converted into the CHI3 or CHCl3 wherever when you make use of the chlorine. And the remaining part gets converted into carboxylic acid CH3COO minus. It can combine the calcium acetate and give. Okay, right. So the answer is option number B. It should answer the chloroform iodoform reagent. Okay. Question number 6. Identify why in the following sequence of reaction. So we have got benzene. When benzene is treated with the nitric acid and sulfuric acid, so nitration we get nitrobenzene. Then treat with the chlorine and then the presence of the ferric chloride. Okay, remember nitro group is a meta directing group. You should go to the meta position, so one of the meta position should be occupied. So we should get nitro to the ortho para sorry meta position. We should get chlorine, should be metachloronitrobenzene. So B is the answer. Clear? Question number 7. Which of the following is present as five-membered cyclic structure, like fructose structure? Ribose we study in DNA RNA. DNA RNA you have studied as a five-membered ring, correct? Glucose is a six-membered ring, you write like this, correct? Maltose is a combination of the two carbohydrate, monosaccharide. And galactose also, it is a six-membered ring, you write like this, correct? Remember? So these are the five, six-membered ring. And ribose is a five-membered tree, so ribose is the answer. Question number 8. In the following reaction, benzene and propene, there is a phosphoric acid compound A, oxygen and acid hydroxide B and C. Now, benzene. Benzene is treated with, CH, double bond CH2. Then, there is a protonation taking place. Phosphoric acid which donates is a proton to the alkene like this, like Markovnikov's rules. We get CH, then CH plus and CH3. Now the benzene attack this carbocation to give final structure would be like this. So we get CH3, CH3 and H. We get a cumene structure. And after cumene, that is the A compound, it is treated with the oxygen to give cumene hydroperoxide. After that, it is subjected to acid hydrolysis to give the phenol and the acetone structure. This is nothing but the preparation or the manufacture of the phenol now, correct? So the answer should be phenol and the acetone. Clear? Right? Question number 9. 0.5 mole of each H2SO2 and CH4 are there in the container. Hole is made in the container. After 3 hours, order the partial pressure. Suppose there is a vessel. In that vessel, hydrogen, sulfur dioxide and CH4 is there. Okay. Now there is a hole which will come. Now through this hole, the gas will come out. Which gas moves faster? According to Graham's law, the rate of diffusion is directly proportional, inversely proportional to molar mass of the gas. Correct? Hydrogen molar mass is 2 gram per mole. Correct, Alva? Sulfur trioxide, it is a 64 grams per mole. Correct? And methane, it is in terms of 16 grams per mole. Which gas comes first? Gas comes first. Hydrogen, light gas, comes out faster. Next, which gas comes out? Okay, methane gas comes out. Then which gas comes out? Sulfur dioxide comes out. Which will remain in the more amount now? Sulfur dioxide will be more in amount. Okay, then which will remain there? CH4 will remain after some time. Then comes which order? Then comes hydrogen, correct? Hydrogen will be least now, remaining. So, which will remain more now? That gas which moves slower. So, sulfur dioxide will be more now. So, partial pressure sulfur dioxide is more compared to CH4 and compared to the hydrogen. Right? So, therefore, answer is option number B. Because lighter gas moves out faster from the vessel, which gas remain but heavier gas will remain. Okay? So, A is the answer. Question number 10. Which of the following set is not possible? Let's see the first one. When n is equal to 3, l is equal to 0, 1 and 2. So 2 is possible. When l is equal to 2, m is equal to 0, plus or minus 1 and plus or minus 2. Correct? So m is equal to 0 possible. When m is equal to 0, s is either plus half or minus half. So first one is possible. What about the second one? When n is equal to 3, l is equal to 2, already possible. When l is equal to 2, m is equal to minus 2, already possible. When m is equal to minus 2, s is equal to minus half is also possible. Correct? Let's see the C option. When n is equal to 3, l is equal to 2, possible. When l is equal to 2, m is equal to minus 3 is not possible. Plus or minus 3 is not there for l is equal to 2. So, therefore, C cannot be, is not possible. Clear? Right? So, C is the answer. Many students are watching these videos. Around 55% who are using, you are watching this video are my subscribers. They already subscribed. And there are 45% of the students who are watching. They are not subscribed. They are unsubscribers. I expect these 45% to subscribe and support me. You have been watching, so I expect you to appreciate my work and please do subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.